So first I should mention that while TL1 is a great initiative for helping the development of the superior varieties in such semi-arid tropic environment, these crops are generally grown by poor farmers in very poor infrastructure. So basically farmers, they don't have the access to the irrigation, they don't have access to the fertilizers. So when they grow the crop, and in such environments crop is heavily, or the crop production is heavily challenged by several biotic stresses like fungal or bacterial diseases or insect, or more importantly the water stress, we call it drought. So what happens, so the crop productivity of these legumes is very low.
TL1 is meant mainly for working on molecular aspect of breeding, germplasm or genetic background enhancement, and it is really a base for developing the technologies on chickpea that fits into the area of interest, like for droughts.
I am the TL1 coordinator in Kenya, and I participate in all the activities of TL1, coordinating my colleagues in the program. I'm also involved in doing germplasm evaluations, looking at genomic resources, and also improving our local germplasm using modern breeding.
Well, so there were some obstacles, but not very serious. So one of the challenge in front of us has been to convince or to motivate the traditional breeders that, well, genomics can make some impact on their breeding program. But I should tell that once you can convince or you can demonstrate the result, then they are very much excited, and then they are ready to accept those application of genomics in breeding program.
We feel to be a little bit challenge, because you know there is a procedure that you have to follow in sending the these genetic materials. There are paths or bureaucratic paths that you have to pass through, administrative paths that you have to pass through, which you feel sometimes hectic. That affects, of course, your efficiency. This is one instance actually, but there are things in line with those things. And also there is problems related to the staff turnovers in some cases, and changes in the natural environment or climate, where we have sometimes a challenge of growing the plants or the planted materials as we are expecting in the field, like when we are planting in the off season using the irrigation. We felt sometimes difficulties having full establishment of the plants. We felt sometimes flower dropping due to the heat up of the that season environment or temperature, and the success of some crossing sometimes could not be as we are expecting. These are a few of the cases, but I would say most of the challenges or obstacles are somewhat manageable.
So for instance, like when we initiated chickpea project, we had two major stresses in front of us. One was insect resistance, another is drought tolerance. And probably we were naive that we thought that insect resistance we can tackle, we can identify some markers, etc. But based on our 3-4 years research, we realized that, well, if you don't have the natural variation in the cultivated gene pool, it's not easy to harness the power of genomics. So in the end, now in the phase 2, we are emphasizing only on the drought stress. So one of the important lessons which we learnt, or our team learnt, is that collaboration is very, very important. So for instance, not the collaboration not only among those scientists who are working on a project, rather if you know that some projects they are doing similar kind of work, and they are working in India or in the US or in Germany, it is always important and good to have the coordinated efforts in different projects, so that in the end we can make the best use of those public resources.
I think one of the lessons that I've learned is that coordinated research from high level research, it can easily be brought down to the NAS level based on very good structure, because we are getting a lot of output and input into the NAS system through coordination of GCP, of high level research that has come down to the national program. So I've learned that it is possible to bring high level genomics up to the farmers level, where the NAS can actually operationalize. So that is one lesson in learned from coordination point of view. The other lesson learned also is that it is possible through concerted efforts to improve productivity at farmers level. So that is a concerted effort. You can improve the yield and the livelihood of the small scale farmers.